what's wrong with men and being stingy, but I think stingy men actually contribute to a lot of topics that people are already talking about in our day-to-day life. Welcome, guys, to another episode of Saloon Talk. This is season 3, and it's your girl, Sabrina Hughes, aka Wild and Free. You are watching Abma TV right now. This show runs every Sunday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. So make sure you tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend to make sure that you tune in and listen to all the trending topics that we are going to be having for you today. Right now, we are at Spectro Saloon in Kamalagala. They have 3 branches, one in Bugolobi, right behind Cafe Montana. The one in Kamalagala here is at Selina Plaza, and the one in Machinde is right opposite the barrack. So guys, these guys, as you can see, they have the best beauty care treatment that I have ever seen before. So make sure you grab yourself. If they have coupons, I'm not very sure, but if you come up to the saloon right here, you're gonna be having all the best care that you want to have for your beauty, whether to cut your hair, whether to do your nails, whether massage, whatever you want, as long as it includes beauty care, they have it right here at Spectra Saloon in Kamalagala. And of course, the CEO herself is in the building. She's gonna introduce herself, and she's gonna be telling you a few of the packages that Spectra Saloon has. Before we go to our lovely, I should call him what? What should I call him? He's my co-worker, but my very lovely friend. He's also gonna introduce himself. But I'm gonna start with the beautiful lady herself, because as they say, ladies first. How are you? I don't want to say your name. I want you to tell the people out there who are watching you who you are, because you look like a boss lady, and you are a boss lady yourself. So to the people out there who are watching you, they want to say hi.
Hello everyone, this is Karen Blackburn, CEO Spectra Saloon and Spa and Properties. Well, I'm gonna say, should I talk about Spectra?
Yeah,
Spectra has been in existence since 2015, for 8 years in service. And we offer all the beauty tips, everything that you want that concerns your beauty, skin care, hair care, massage, foot care, everything. Like literally we cover up all the beauty tips, beauty needs that you need.
I think in all the saloons I've been to, this is the first saloon that has actually given me a glass of, some cold wine to cool down my... Oh, thank you for that. Thank you so much.
Thank you. We always try to make our customers and guests comfortable.
Thank you.
That's what we always do.
of course.
So, yeah.
Thank you so much for having us. They say what? Men last, men come later, whatever it is. But the gentleman in the building is going to introduce himself. What's going on? Tell the lovely ladies out there who are watching you what your lovely name is, and if you're single or not, just in case.
Actually, by saying men last, I can say that is a trap. We always come last, but we come stronger.
Just
save the best for the last.
Okay.
Yes, good evening, our viewers. My name is Bruce Twesij. Some people call me Omchiga Kashushu. Yeah, proud of my heritage, that is Kabale. Shout outs to people in Kabale, my relatives, all of you, I greet you in Jesus' name. Yes, I am a media practitioner, I am a video editor, I am a graphics creator, I'm a photographer, name it. Anything concerning media, I'm here.
You're a part of it. Okay, so our guests are acquainted with you guys. So we're going to just jump right into the topic of today, which is DNA and its validity. Is DNA important? Is it relevant? Or is it just something people really talk about just to make their social media active or something? Before we go into the in-depth analysis of DNA as a topic, what do you understand when someone tells you DNA? What comes to your mind the first thing?
Yeah, thank you very much. When you talk about DNA, it's like someone is, you're trying to prove a point whether you are a biological father or maybe you belong somewhere that people are questioning. That's why you see we talk about DNA all the time, or maybe you're not sure of your origin or your parents or where you come from.
Okay, all right. So Bruce, we were talking about with this Bruce before we started the show, and Bruce told me I have to tell the people what DNA means in full, and I'm like, Bruce,
roll
all
it.
I know it has acid.
Roll it. Roll it.
All I know it has acid, and since he's well versed and he's a media photographer, video creator, whatever multi-purpose guy, he's gonna tell us what DNA in full stands for.
Okay, first of all, the D in the DNA is hard to pronounce. And
but you can try.
Considering that I'm from that place where we speak with a lot of strength, I will not crack your sound, your TV set sounds. But all I can tell you is it has something to do with acid. The N is nucleic acid. The D, please, you all have smartphones and I'm sure you have data on them, please.
Just
go down to your phones and Google what the D stands for. Yeah.
Okay, guys. So in a layman's language, we're talking about DNA, which majority of us know as child testing or testing of your genes to know where you come from and where you belong. We are basing on major stories that are going around in Kampala or going around in Africa where children that are for someone or for some man sometimes end up being not for that specific man when they are from someone else. So as my first question for today is, do you think DNA testing is important or it is not?
Very important.
Why?
There is nothing wrong in being sure. There is no wrong in being sure. Yeah. Bagamba okufana na si Uganda. So much as your kids may look like you, It's really important for you to go an extra mile to find out whether they are actually yours. Yeah, no pun intended.
Yeah. Oh, actually, I think that's very... What do you think, Carol? Do you think if at all... Because obviously in Africa, as a setting, DNA testing is not really a very important thing compared to the Western world. You as a person, as an entrepreneur, do you think DNA testing between couples is really important or it's just a by the way?
For me, when you bring it to an African context, and it also depends on the circumstance, the timing, you understand? Because most cases, we time the DNA at the wrong time, DNA testing at the wrong time, and the circumstance when we're testing. So if maybe it's at the start of the phase, the starting point, but you find a place where someone is 46, he grew up somewhere and is asking for a DNA test. For what?
For what, yeah.
For maybe this one below 18, I will agree. But again, in African context, most cases, the agreements that people put across in marriages, whereby maybe there's an agreement, a man is unimportant. So he agrees with the wife to, maybe we have that scenario at home, where someone agreed with the wife, you get. So, you can't pin it on a man or a woman. Like I said, it depends on the circumstances why you're testing. If the man is not comfortable with the situation, yeah, it's okay. But for me, I cannot agree with someone going for DNA at 46 years because I saw something trending on what? On media.
Yeah.
Maybe when the kids are still young, that's okay. And you but
you want to be sure.
Yes, yeah. But once the kids are really bonded. We are in Africa where kids, we call omusajja tebamuwa bana, n'omukazi tebamuwa ki bana. Like the circumstance varies mostly for me. If you ask me that
question. Actually, omukazi bamuwa bana.
Bamuwa bana.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it depends.
Because you are in a better position to really acknowledge that it's your child.
But why would you go for DNA test? Yes.
Like I said,
why are you not sure?
You see,
where were you when your wife was running?
Carol,
around?
From your school of thought, I will not go against this because you're a woman and you are sure of your kids, by the way, because you're in the hospital and you, as soon as it pops out, they put it up and they ask you, what sex is this baby? And you look, if there is something protruding, it's a boy. If it's a girl. So. I understand when you say it is not necessary, but for a man who is not up to speed with where you pass, where you move, I still affirm it that it is important.
Like I said, it's necessary and not necessary.
And then the timing, I feel like Carol is diverting us from what we actually need to know. She's talking about timing of 40 years and above. Can we tone it down to a little younger age? Yeah.
Okay. All right. Okay. Okay, guys. So There is a recent story that has been going around social media for over like a week now. A business tycoon known as Samona, aka Michael, he has 25 kids that are confirmed. And then recently, 10, he realized, he took a DNA test for all his 25 kids and realized that 10 of those kids were not biologically his. Obviously, we cannot remove the fact that he is their father, because being a father does not mean that you have to be that person's biological, you know, parent. But he found out that they were not biologically his. And that, you know, there was a lot going on. We do not know exactly what is going on between the family, but what we know as media, as the people right now, we know that there were circumstances to as why those kids ended up not being his and was lied to that they were his.
What prompted
Can I know about the circumstances?
What prompted him?
That there are circumstances.
They are not validated, because like I said, we are not in a relationship. But as what the media knows is that there is one of his wives claims to have been sexually assaulted by one of the employees. That's why most of the children are not his, among the 10.
Why should you wait for such circumstances to happen?
Yeah. That's an excuse to drive away your woman. Because if you're that rich and you're really keen about your children, why didn't he do it on the first day of the birth, or 2 months, 3 months, and wait for 10 years? I don't know how old the kids are. Why now?
I'm going to pause you guys there for a little bit. Let us go for a commercial break. We are still talking about this topic. Go down to our social media platform, that's Saloon Talk, hashtag Urban TV, and put in your opinion on this topic, because we only have 3 opinions here and we would want to hear your view about it. Let us go for a commercial break. When we come back, we still have more.